SM and welcome to my channel Concept of Mechanical Engineering. Here we are studying thermodynamics. In thermodynamics, in previous class we have seen types of thermometer, where we have studied the first type, which is resistance thermometer, which is also called as thermistor. Today we will see the second type of thermometer, which is thermocouple. It is based on Seebeck's effect. It is based on Seebeck's effect. So according to Seebeck's effects, when two dissimilar metals are joined to form two junctions, and if these two junctions are maintained at different temperatures, then an EMF or voltage is induced between the two junctions, and this EMF or voltage is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the two junctions. So according to Seebeck's effects, when two dissimilar metals are joined to form two junctions, and if these two junctions are maintained at different temperatures, then an EMF or voltage is induced between the two junctions, and this EMF or voltage is directly proportional to the change in temperature difference between the two junctions. So according to Seebeck's effect, when two dissimilar metals are joined to form two junctions, and if these two junctions are maintained at different temperature, then an EMF or voltage is induced, and this voltage is directly proportional to the temperature difference between the two junctions. Let us consider this with an example. We have these two dissimilar metals, and we have joined these two dissimilar metals to form two junctions. One is kept at 0 degree centigrade, which is ice, and other as 100 degree centigrade, which is steam. So according to Seebeck's effects, an EMF or voltage is induced. This voltage is directly proportional to temperature difference between the two junctions. So V equals to KT, K delta T, where K is constant. So V is equal to K temperature, delta T means temperature of steam minus temperature of ice. So this we know because temperature of steam is 100 degree centigrade and temperature of ice is 0 degree centigrade. So from there K is known. It is known because this V is the voltage which can be known by measuring. So if we are from there, we will know the value of the constant K. If we want to measure the temperature of the body, so we will connect this system. These two decimeters, we have joined these two decimeters, and one side we kept 0 degree centigrade, that is ice, and in other junction we put body whose temperature is TB. So again we have joined these two decimeters, and at one junction we kept ice which is at 0 degree centigrade, and other junction we have connected body which is at TB temperature. So according to this law, an EMF will be induced, that is we call it as V dash, and V dash is directly proportional to delta T dash. V dash equals to K delta T dash. V dash equals to K TB minus temperature body minus temperature of ice which is 0 degree centigrade. Where we can measure this induced voltage, and we know the value of K also. So from there temperature of body will be known. Hence from there we can measure the temperature of the body. Here TB is the temperature of body. Hence voltage plays the role of thermometric property. We can note one thing. Thermocouple uses copper constantan or platinum rhodium combinations. So in thermocouple, voltage plays the role of thermometric property, and thermocouple uses copper constantan or platinum rhodium combinations. Now we will see the third type, which is constant pressure gas thermometer. It is based on, it is a gas thermometer. So here we can apply the ideal gas equation PV equals to MRT. Since pressure is constant, V is directly proportional to temperature, hence volume plays the role of thermometric property. The other type is constant volume gas thermometer. Here also we can apply the ideal gas equation PV equals to MRT. since volume is constant, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. Hence, pressure plays the role of thermometric property. One thing we can note, ideal gas thermometer is independent from the material of construction. That is, constant pressure and constant volume thermometer.